गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम मिसेस स्वाति धमाले, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डी वाय पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, आकुर्डी, पुणे. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कार्बन फुटप्रिंट असेसमेंट ऑफ मशीन टूल्स. एंड दिस वीडियो आई एम प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द इंटरनेशनल फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम ऑन एनवायरमेंट एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी विच इज ऑर्गेनाइज बाय डी वाय पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, आकुर्डी, पुणे. So this is the brief content of week 1 and week 2 videos. In week 1, I discussed about how mechanical engineering in collaboration with other engineering streams working towards environment and sustainability. In week 2, I discussed about how or what is the difference between the life cycle assessment and design of environment or design for environment and various approaches towards design for environment. After learning these videos, the student can understand the importance of mechanical engineering to work towards environment and sustainability. What is the difference between life cycle assessment and design for environment? What are the different approaches towards design for environment? What are the importance of carbon footprint assessment and how carbon footprint assessments done in specific application? Here we can see the various ISO standards and what is the purpose and how it is applicable for our intended application. So first one is the ISO 14001 and ISO 14004. So ISO 14001 is the environmental management system. ISO 14001 addresses not only the environmental aspects of the organization process but also those of its products and services also. ISO 14004 provides the additional guidance towards the environmental management. So ISO 14001 and ISO 14004 give guidelines of environmental management in developing any component of part. Second one is ISO 14031, which provides guidance on how an organization can evaluate its environmental performance. Companies can evaluate their products for environment guidelines. The next guideline we can use for my application is ISO 14064 part 1, 2, 3. These are the integral greenhouse gas accounting and verification standards which provide a set of clear and verifiable requirements to support organization and proponents of GHG emission reduction projects. So companies ensures what are the various standards requirements of the GHG emissions. Their next one is ISO 14069, which will provide guidance for organizations to calculate the carbon footprint of their products, services and supply chain. Companies can calculate their products carbon footprint here. So our today's topic is how to measure the carbon footprint. Here we will firstly discuss what is carbon footprint and then we will discuss the case study. So what is carbon footprint? Carbon footprint is a measure of carbon dioxide emissions that affects global warming in a product. The calculation of carbon footprint is a product based on LCA and global warming potential. PAS 2050 and ISO 14067 are the standard for guiding the calculation processes of carbon footprint. So here today we are going to assess the carbon footprint for machine tool. So in case of machines tool, we divide the machine tool into three categories. First is the standard component of the machine tools. So in standard component, the coefficient of carbon footprint of manufacturing process for each standard component can be obtained from suppliers directly or calculated from the information of bill of material and the engineering drawing of the standard component. The next is machine component. The carbon footprint of manufacturing process of the machine component can be obtained by multiplying the weight of removable material with coefficient of carbon footprint of manufacturing process. And these coefficients are directly fed into the carbon footprint software. Then third is the use, transportation and end of life stages. The major carbon footprint sources been considered in use stage is the consumption of electricity and lubrication oil. The calculation of carbon footprint for transportation and end of life stages are the same as for other types of product. So here we are going to study the case study. The case study is for the EMVC machine tool designed by ITRI. So the EMVC machine tool designed by ITRI is selected as a design example to demonstrate the carbon footprint calculations. The specifications of EMVC machine tool is as shown in the figure, as shown in the table. The machine tool can be divided into six subsystems such as tool magazine, working table, column, base, saddle and headstock. So you can just see the specifications of EMVC machine tool. So the weight is approximately 10,184 kg. Maximum speed is 11 kW. Operation rate of the spindle is 70%. Life of the spindle is 7 years. Electricity consumption of the peripheral equipments is 1 kW and transportation is 50 km. So after that, the processes of the carbon footprint calculation of EMVC's machine tool can be divided into four stages such as production stage, use stage, transportation stage and then end of life stage. The machine tool is transported 50 km by using 16 tons truck. So here you can see the carbon footprint calculations for tool magazine. The equivalent CO2 carbon footprint is 160 equivalent kg is 168.98 kg and its approximate percentage is 2.90. For working table it is 2895.49, approximately 49.71%. For column it is 1153.36, approximately 19.80%. For base it is 929.07, approximately 15%. For saddle 410.41, that is approximately 7.04%. And for headstock 267.91, approximately 4.6%. So here also you can see that in the production stage also the carbon footprint generation is more in working table, but we have to generally check for the whole machine. So here is the table for carbon footprint of EMVC machine tool. In the production stage, carbon footprint is 9543.02 kg of CO2, approximately 2.83%. In the use stage, 3,26,492.2, that means approximately 97%. End of life it's 0. Transportation 119, that is approximately 0.03%. So you can conclude from this, this is the pie chart for the carbon footprint for the machine. So you can conclude that the value and percentage of the carbon footprint of the EMVC machine tool, you can see conclude that carbon footprint of the machine tool is dominated by the use stage. The percentage of carbon footprint in production stage of EMVC machine tool is only 2.83%, and in the huge stage it is approximately 97%. However, it is the second large stage in life cycle of the EMVC machine tool. So as we can see from the table, in the transportation etc., very less carbon footprint is generated. So again, we have to discuss the different ways to achieve sustainability in the machine tool manufacturing. So there are various tools by which we can achieve the sustainability in machine tools also. Some of them are, you can save resources with durable products, efficiency can be sustainable, one machine for everything, you can use save raw materials through better preparation, recycling of the waste, less lubrication, consider the CO2 balance of the supply chain, then more precise softwares, artificial intelligence prevents idling, and paying attention to the sustainability of the raw materials. So these are some specific ways of by using which we can achieve the sustainability of the machine. For preparing this, thank you. For preparing this video, I have taken references from Chen, Su and Huang paper published on 20th CIRP International Conference on Life Cycle Engineering, Environmental Management, ISO 1400 family of the international standards, and some internet sources. Thank you once again.